Hello beautiful people, this is Krishna and I welcome you to my channel Code Era. This is the first video on my channel where I am going to explain you each and everything about how to create a parallax scrolling effect using lax.js library. Before moving further, if you are new to my channel, I just want you to subscribe to my channel and even hit the bell icon so you get notified whenever the videos are uploaded on my channel. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Before writing the code, let's first understand what actually is lax.js library. So according to Google, lax.js is a lightweight vanilla JavaScript library that provides 20 plus awesome animations for elements when scrolling up and down. So this was the brief introduction about lax.js. Now let's write and understand what actually is lax.js and how to implement it. Okay, so let me just open up my VS Code editor. Okay, so here it is. Here you can see I have created a HTML file and a CSS file. So in this HTML file, now I'm going to type the exclamation and hit the enter key. By this we will get a user boilerplate for the jumpstart of our code journey. Now let's create a div element with a class attribute container, and within this container let's create a child element with the id child, and then include our style.css file into this HTML file for styling our HTML elements. Okay, now in the CSS file, let's set the margin and padding to 0 and box sizing to border box for each and every element of our web page using the universal selector asterisk. And then set the font size of the HTML to 62.8%, which is approximately 10 pixels in size. Now let's set the height of our web page to 200vh by targeting the body element. Okay, so now it's time to style our most important element of our web page, and that is the child element of our container. So now I will target the child element by its id name child and give it a height and width of 30rem along with a gradient background color, and even give a border radius of 5 pixels to it. Now let's have a look on our page. Okay, so here you can see the blue box aligned at the top left corner of our page. So now let's try to center this element by targeting its parent element, that is the container. Now what I will do is, in our CSS file, I will just position the parent element to absolute and move 100% from the top and 50% from the left, and then center the element accurately by using the CSS transform property. Okay, now let's have a look at our page. Okay, so here you can see the box is moved from top and left and perfectly aligned at the center of the page. So now it's time to implement lax.js into our code. So let me just open up a new tab in the Chrome browser and then type in the name lax.js. So here you can see the first link of GitHub, and when we click on this, we will be redirected directly to the lax.js repository of GitHub. Okay, so here it is. So here you can find an animated video that's showing some of examples or the animation using this library. So when we scroll down here, you will see a subheading named HTML setup, of which you just need to copy this second link and just paste it in our HTML file. And then back from this setup section, you just need to copy this entire code and paste it in our body section of our HTML file. Okay, so back in the Chrome, when you scroll down, you will find a preset section in this page, from where you just need to copy this class attribute along with its value and paste it in the element where you have created the child element, by which this will be the class attribute of the child element. Now let's have a look on our page. Okay, so here you can see the animation happening on the box. When you scroll down, the box simply just spins from left to right direction, and when you scroll up the page, the box spins in right to left direction. Okay, so this was the first example where I have shown you how to spin a box using the lax.js. So now let's try some more example of this library. So here back in the page of GitHub, here you will find a preset explorer link and by clicking on this you will be redirected to a page, and on this Lags Preset Explorer page you will find a list of properties that can be used in our code, and you will find a preview page where they have shown some of awesome animations using these properties. So now what I will do is uncheck this fade in out option and the seesaw option from this property window, and then we will just try this fade in out property for our component. So let me just check in the box and copy this from the below provided section and paste this into the value of our class attribute, just like this. Okay, now let's look at our page how the code is working. So here you can see when I scroll down the page, the box starts to fade in, and when I scroll back to the top, the box starts to fade out. Okay, so this was the second example. Now let's try one more example so you can get a clear idea how to use and implement this in your code. So now I will just go back to the Lags Preset Explorer page and check this scale in out option and keep the fade in out option checked so that I can get a special effect on my box. So now let's just copy this from here and just paste it in our HTML file. Okay, so here you can see the increase in the size of the box along with the increase in the opacity of the box, and the same thing happens in the reverse direction when you scroll back to the top of the page. So now I just want you to play around these values so that you get a better understanding of how this Lags.js library works and how you can get a hand on it. So that's all for today guys. Before leaving, if you like the video, I just want you to like and share this video, and do let me know in the comment section that should I continue to bring detailed tutorials on this channel, or are you okay with the videos that are been uploaded before this video. So see you in the next video guys. Till then, take care. Bye bye.